I wish I were better at drinking, because I love sex. Which is weird, because I usually only love things I'm good at, like badminton and drinking hot chocolate. I was always afraid of sex in high school, you know? Because the levels of experience are so lopsided. Like, I remember I was banging out with this girl, and she whispered in my ear, "Rape me." And I didn't even know what to do, because I hadn't even had sex regular. I wasn't really ready for the ropes course, you know? And I was thinking, if I had done it, it would have been the lightest rape of her life. Like, I'd have to disclaim it. Like, "I'm letting you off easy this time." But sex is weird, you know? It's like tennis. Like, you need to find someone of your own ability. Because if they're better than you, it's awkward. It's like they're wailing the ball at you, and you're like, "I'm not getting anything over here! Do you have, like, an underhand serve or a lob? You've taken a lot of lessons! Aren't you worried about tennis elbow?" Some people are very confident about sex. They videotape themselves, which I've never understood. After I have sex, all I can think is, at least no one saw it. That's why I get so uncomfortable when I watch this show. There's this show, Real Sex, on HBO. It's like this documentary sex show. It's like these unwieldy middle-aged couples, like, masturbating in a circle in a mountain somewhere. And I just know in 5 years from now, they're gonna come to their senses and be like, "I wasn't masturbating on television, was I? Oh no! I didn't high-five penises with the instructor, did I? Oh dear God!" But porn is, like, huge. It's, like, it is a bigger industry than I'd ever imagined. Like, I'll be traveling around the country, driving in the middle of nowhere. There's no food or gas. There's no food or gas, but there's billboards that are like, "Pull over, we got porn." And there's so many, there's actually billboards next to those that are anti-porn. I saw one, it said, "Porn destroys lives." For a split second, I thought that was a specific type of porn. Like, I go in and be like, "Do you guys have that porn that destroys lives?" It's kind of my thing, you know, I just seemed interesting.
They're having everybody has watched porn at this point. Even the panda bears are watching porn. At the zoo here, at the National Zoo, you know that they're having a hard time getting the pandas to mate because the male pandas like eating more than they like mating, which I can understand. If I were a panda and I have sex with another panda, I wouldn't be that excited either. I'd be like, "Oh great, she looks exactly like me." "Can I get a bamboo sandwich or something?" So what they're doing is they're showing the pandas porn to get them to mate. And I want to know, is it panda porn, or is it human porn, or is it humans dressed like panda porn? Which is some kinky panda porn that I might be interested in if it destroys lives. If it's human porn and I were a panda bear, I'd be like, "Yeah, I'll have sex with her. I'm sure I'm gonna have sex with her." And if it's panda porn, how could those pandas have sex with each other in the movie? Let's get that director on board. And that lead panda actor, the John Holmes of pandas. He's like, "I do all the panda hoes. Black, white, black and white." But I feel bad for these pandas, you know. Because they poop up to 135 times a day. That's gotta be hard to have a serious conversation. You're like, "Honey, we need to talk. Oh my God. go behind a tree or something. I know we're bears, but come on. Oh, there goes me. Sorry about that.
I love going to the zoo, you know? I love it, man. They have zoos everywhere, though. They have zoos in places they shouldn't even have zoos. I went to a small town called Erie, Pennsylvania, and they had a zoo. But it was just like the guy in town with the most animals. He was like, these are the penguins. I was like, that's a dog. And this is the hammerhead shark. That's a half a can of tuna fish. And the dog just ate it. Half of your zoo is gone.